And now, Behind the Scenes International Report with TBN founder and president, Paul Crouch. Join us for Paul's Around the World Daily Report to you, our partners.
And I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I am doubly blessed today, dear friends. The doctor is in, Dr. Raafat Girgis.
Dr. Crouch, thank you for inviting me.
From Egypt. And Pastor Robert Kayanja.
Yes, sir.
From Uganda.
Yes,
Kampala,
sir.
Uganda. In a moment, I'll have you just tease us a little bit. He has a very special gift, really, for all of us, and it will be on display here at TBN, and we'll tell you about it in just a moment. But Dr. Girgis, believe it or not, this is your new Al-Hurriya Arabic language set.
Praise the Lord.
We watched it being built, you know.
Yes.
And we were hoping for the day and praying for the day it would be finished. And look, there's the beautiful new. And that is the Arabic words for
Al-Hurriya.
Al-Hurriya, which means?
Freedom.
Freedom.
Yes.
So it's the new Freedom Channel.
Yes.
And what an appropriate name to take precious Arab people, Egyptians and others, out of
bondage
into the glorious freedom of the gospel. I love the new name and your new logo. And dear friends,
actually the new logo has a very prophetic meaning. We can get into that.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. On top of that, I understand you had one more live program today.
Yes. Uh-huh.
You know, it's just blowing my mind as to how you can do. It's through the internet, isn't it? It goes live to Egypt. But now, see, you're, what, 8 or 9 hours different. So what time do you have to do your program?
We do it as a prime time in Egypt, which was 12 noon here, which is 9 p.m. over there.
Ah.
And 9 to 12 is really the highest viewership in the Middle East.
So for some reason, the fact that it's live and they can telephone in and talk to a prayer partner, it's a big deal over in Egypt.
And they come on air and they will be heard here in the studio. They will talk to us, we will talk to them, and we are going to exchange whatever they are asking for or looking for or praying for. Today we have Father McCary, and the phone was off the hook. People were calling from Germany, from the Netherlands, England, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, the Gulf area, Libya.
Arab speakers?
Yes.
All over Europe?
All over Europe and the Middle East.
What are the Arabs doing all up in Europe?
Oh, well, they are trying to Muslimize.
Oh.
Islamize the...
Really?
Yeah.
I have a feeling some of them are running away from Islam, are they not?
Well, some, definitely when they get out of their countries with all the restrictions and the customs and everything, and they find freedom the wrong way, they go into all kind of, improper things.
Yes, yes. I want to come back and I want some testimonies. But real quickly, Pastor Kayanja, Miracle Center Cathedral, dear friends, a church of how many members?
32,000.
32,000 members. I'm told that Uganda is aflame with revival.
Dr. Paul, first of all, I want to thank you and TBN partners for the work they are doing. Most of your partners here in the United States have no idea of what TBN has been doing. But me, I was 11 years old when you obeyed God to start TBN. Mm-hmm. So from that moment on, now I'm a pastor of a great church in Kampala, Uganda, but also have 3,000 branches connected to that one church.
All over Uganda?
All over Uganda and East Africa.
And outside of Uganda?
And outside Uganda.
Really?
So many churches all over Africa have used TBN as a litmus test for Bible school studies, because most of them don't have a chance to go for Bible school.
Right.
So they have learned how to preach the gospel, because after you watch T.D. Jakes, Benny Hinn, and others, you have to change your way of preaching, Joyce Meyer and others.
Yes, yes.
So TBN is not only just a television channel putting up programs, it's literally teaching the body of Christ what to do, how to function, and the Holy Spirit as well.
Pastor, hold it right there. I want to come back in a moment. You have a very special gift, I know, for all of the TBN partners,
yes,
and
please.
I'm anxious to see it and show it.
Yes.
But lest I forget, be sure when you go back to Kampala, your capital city, please tell President Museveni how much I appreciate him and his dear First Lady. You remember you brought me a letter, was it 2 years ago?
About 3 years ago.
3 years ago, inviting me to come and meet the President and his dear wife. And I was very ill at the time and could not go. So I sent my dear son Matthew and Lori, his sweet wife. And they brought me back a wonderful report. And okay, there they are. Actually, is this?
Yeah, that is the President. We had a big meeting for the Body of Christ, which had organized for you to come and address. And there, Matthew Crouch hugs the President. Now,
is
Matthew,
that
it's
is
something
the president.
Else. Yeah, that's the President Museveni.
Okay.
You know, presidents are not hugged, but Matthew with the Holy Spirit, you know Matthew Crouch.
Yes.
He went there and I told him, Matthew, you want to cause me trouble? Why do you go and hug the President? But
he,
you know,
accepted
he's a man
it.
For. Yes, he went there and the President accepted him.
That's
we
sweet.
Went on a presidential private jet. We toured the whole country.
Oh,
we went and the TBN did a good documentary. Matthew Crouch did a great work. That's he was with the President. President in Uganda, all of those people around him, apart from me, but all presidential guards.
You know, it's just so amazing to me, Pastor. Pitiful Uganda went from hell,
to revival.
To heaven, almost, yes.
It is literally incredible.
Idi Amin, he slaughtered how many of his people?
About 800,000 people.
Almost a million people.
Almost a million people.
What was his purpose for killing them?
Of course, Idi Amin was empowered by Gaddafi, and they wanted to Islamize the nation. And of course, he was one of the reckless dictators you have ever seen. But Idi Amin is only the only problem. We had Milton Obote, we had other dictators that followed.
Yes.
Until Museveni led the People's Protracted War of Liberation, and peace came to Uganda. Oh. And as a result, we have seen tremendous, tremendous revival.
Oh, wow.
50 years ago, we celebrated, a year ago, we celebrated the 50 years of independence.
And that's what you're going to show me
and
here
this
in
is what
a
we're
moment.
Going to show you today.
Okay. Oh,
this
I
is the.
I need an hour. Don't show it yet.
Okay.
I want to tease them a little bit.
Okay.
And I want you to get ready for a treat.
Yes.
For now, I want to get back to Egypt and the Muslim Middle East. And I've got this little roll-in from my nephew, Rick Ridings, from Jerusalem. In a moment, I'll show that. But first, I've got to hear. Tell me some testimonies. What did you hear? People phoning in live from all over Europe and
from
the Middle East.
From all over Europe, the Middle East, Canada, the United States.
What are they saying? What are they asking?
Well, they're asking for prayer. They're asking how to know God. And they are commenting on the new channel and that they were waiting for it. They really congratulated everybody. They feel that everything in the channel is really what they were looking for.
Wow.
And they are very excited. They were calling us to say, you know, I need to see these programs. I need to this kind of program, youth programs, stuff about the Bible school. Everything was revolving around that.
Speaking of Bible school, we have created an Arabic language Bible school, haven't we?
But now as we expand and the healing and the Al-Hurriya is just, there is massive need for those people coming out of Islam to be educated about what Christ is.
Because
all what they have is just an experience, an encounter with the Lord.
Yeah.
But they don't know the Bible, they have not been discipled. So it's really amazing what this channel can do.
So you know, I know you're wise enough to be telling all these people, now tell your neighbors how to get Al-Hurriya on what? Hot Bird number 13 satellite?
Yeah. On Hubbard and on
Nilesat
and on Optus D2 in Australia and New Zealand.
Everyone that calls can be a little missionary themselves to tell others how
Absolutely.
To get.
Yes.
Because they have to have the little dish, don't
right.
they, to receive it.
Yeah.
And now we're still giving away dishes to Egypt?
In Egypt, we halted it for a little while because of the security risks.
Trouble.
Because when the Muslim Brotherhood just took over for the past year and a half, they really, you know, almost damaged everything in the country. But now, thank God for June 30th revolution, where they were overthrown, in my opinion, by a divine intervention.
Amen.
It's nothing like that in the history of mankind, that 33 million people, one third of the country, took the streets of Cairo and the rest of the nation. Mm. If you see Dr. Crouch from Google Earth and see a sea of people, it's unbelievable, never recorded in history of mankind. It was God wanted to show the true face of Islam and how destructive it can be, because we were on the road to be another Iran. Now everybody, after this 1.5 year of hell, they know exactly that this is not what they are asking for. And now we are coming with the Freedom Channel to say, you know what we were looking for all these years.
Here it is.
And it started maybe in the physical on June 30th. Now we are here in July. We are telling you about the true freedom in Jesus Christ.
Partners, look what God has done. We couldn't have figured this out. This is a divine intervention.
Absolutely.
But our prayers should be for Egypt and for those,
amen,
because the Christians are suffering, aren't they, in some
way, many ways. The
Christians
are suffering because some of those people left over from the old regime, the Muslim Brotherhood, they are going after the weak people or the people who are very peaceful.
But the military that's in charge, they're not necessarily Muslim, are they?
No. The military actually sided with the people and decided to overthrow the other guy. Not in a coup. They are just respecting the will of the people. If you have one third of the country outside just saying, go, what can you do?
Oh, boy. Well, Egypt should be in all of our prayers.
And this is opening a way for TBN to have a foot inside Egypt, like Israel.
Yeah.
Isaiah 19, I know that TBN will have something big in Egypt coming, and it will be really used as a tool by the Lord for Isaiah 19 to come to pass.
Dr. Girgis, I think we already have something pretty big in Egypt, in the Middle East right now, with the Al-Hawriya, the Victory Channel.
Yes, the Freedom Channel.
Freedom Channel. Freedom. Yeah. Well,
which
freedom and victory.
It
could be either one, yes. Real quickly, time is flying and we're having such a good time. My little nephew, as you know, has a wonderful ministry over in Jerusalem, and now he's going to other countries and open up these 24-hour-a-day prayer chains in the various countries. He just came from Turkey recently. But Rick is there, and he's
a wonderful man of God.
A watchman on the wall, and he sent us this fresh little report. It's about 2-3 minutes. Watch your screens for just a moment.
Hello, this is Rick Ridings coming to you with Watchmen on the Walls of Jerusalem. We're filming in the Ben Hinnom Valley. That is the very famous valley in the scriptures. It talks about children and babies being sacrificed to an idol called Molech. And it's a picture of how in this generation, Satan wants to kill and destroy the children and the youth. But praise God, God is raising up a new standard. And we thank the Lord that here at Israel, He's allowed us to have a youth conference. This year will be our 7th youth conference that will bring together hundreds of Jewish and Arab and Palestinian believers to worship, pray, seek the Lord together, pray for each other, become friends out of this. And I have today with us a special guest who is a young man who was actually raised mostly in Gaza. And he's been involved for 6 years now at these conferences with us. And we welcome you. And I'd like to ask you, what has been something of your experience in these conferences as a young Arab believer?
First of all, I would like to share a verse. Love your enemies as yourself. And it's not about Jewish, it's not about Arab, it's about His love. Usually we have every year in Elav something called like break up the walls between Jewish and Arabs. God can do it in your life too, to love your enemies, to love everyone. It's not about hating, it's about really God loves, cast out fear. You want to experience this, ask God to pour out His love in your life.
is this something that just happens once a year, or are there people who are starting to have friendships and relationships, like with you? Do you have a friendship with a Jewish believer?
For example, every week I am having a worship time with a Jewish leader. His name is Stefan, and he's an amazing friend. And thank God for this young man that he seeks God, and he loves Arabs too, and he loves to see God's working in Arab communities.
This particular valley that we mentioned, the Ben Hinnom Valley, in the Bible it said it was cursed because of the babies and children offered as sacrifices to demonic powers. And I remember my wife and I went on a tour, and the tour guide said this. He said, you know, we Jewish people believe this Ben Hinnom Valley was cursed because of the sacrifice of children. And the way we knew it was cursed was that for hundreds and hundreds of years there have been no birds in this valley. But then he said, I don't know what happened. About 3 months ago, the birds came back, and now there are birds in this valley again. So we believe even as this valley has been redeemed and life has come back, life can come to this generation. Pray for an outpouring of life upon the young people of Israel and the Middle East.
Dr. Girgis, your Al Haraya is going into the Holy Land as well.
Yes, absolutely.
Many, many Arabs there.
Absolutely.
And I know they're watching on their little dishes.
They are.
Now it's all even going into the Jewish homes now. TBN is everywhere, we say now.
Amen.
Oh, my goodness. We've got to hurry now. Pastor Kayanja from Kampala, Uganda. We saw those beautiful pictures of your president, and as I said to you earlier, please don't forget to tell the president how much we love and admire him and his wonderful first lady. They're strong, outspoken Christians, and how we honor them for that. And I am planning, the Lord willing, to come later this year, and I would love to meet him.
We will be blessed to have you. And we want to present to you.
Yes.
And everybody.
Okay, here's our big surprise, folks.
This is our 50th anniversary.
See, you've,
book
you've
that
trumped,
they put
you've
together.
TBN. We only have our 40th anniversary book.
This is Building of a Nation, 148 Shapers and Movers of Uganda's Past and Present. So we want to present this one to you, Dr. Paul.
But you said, and your picture is in there somewhere.
Yes, I wanted to show you the picture of the president, because there were many, many terrible presidents, but this is the picture of our president, beloved President Yoram 7. He has done incredible, incredible work. I hope I'll be able to get it there.
There it is.
That is his picture when he was holding the new Uganda constitution, swearing in as an elected president, which is a miracle from the dictators.
Oh, absolutely.
And among the 148 personalities, my picture and my wife's picture is over there.
There you are.
And that is our congregation, the church in Uganda.
My goodness.
And
now, it looks like your people, are you outside there?
No, we are inside the church.
How many does the church seat?
10,500.
So you have to have three services.
We have just four services on Sunday.
Four services.
Yes, four services.
Oh, my goodness.
Sunday. So we want to present this to you, Dr. Paul,
for the great work you
have done in Uganda through TBN.
Aye.
And the work has been totally incredible.
My goodness.
Incredible.
You left a $1 bill in there. Do I get to keep that?
Yes, please.
To mark your picture.
Yes, please.
This is amazing, and I promise you this will go into our little museum at TCCI and Costa Mesa, our TBN International Headquarters building. When you come to California, Southern California, I'll tell you what, though, I'll bet you my wife, Jan, she'll want to steal this from me and want to take it to
Holy Land.
The Holy Land experience down there, where they have also a museum. We'll fight over this. Maybe we'll trade it back and forth a little bit. But please tell your president our sincere thanks for this. And
yes,
boy, this is amazing. This is really amazing.
It is really. The only thing we can do as people of Uganda is to pray for you, Dr. Paul, to pray for the partners of TBN, Mama Jane Crouch, for the great work you have done. Many of us have benefited enormously from the work TBN has done. It is just unbelievable. It has caused revival around the world.
Does this also tell the story of how Idi Amin had
slaughtered?
No, captured the people at the Entebbe airport?
Yeah, it tells the whole story.
Does
of
it?
50 years. It tells the whole story. Everything from Idi Amin, from Kony, from revival, from
But the
everything.
Thrilling part of that story is
yes.
the Israeli IDF came down and liberated those prisoners. Only one person was killed.
Was killed by Idi Amin, yes.
And it happened to be Prime Minister
Netanyahu's brother.
Netanyahu's own brother.
Yes.
Was the one killed in the liberation of those people mm-hmm. that Idi Amin had captured and was holding hostage.
Hostage, yes.
In the Entebbe.
Actually, it was the Palestinian that captured the French airliner. And then took them to Egypt. Egypt refused them. Mm-hmm. Then Idi Amin welcomed them, which was also a miracle because probably they would have been killed. But by coming to Uganda, they were saved, except one.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
Well, Pastor, I can't thank you enough. This is wonderful. And again, just take our love and our appreciation to your president, President Museveni, and his dear wife, First Lady.
Yes.
And they tell me that she's just an amazing lady and a real fireball
she
for Jesus.
She is a preaching machine. She's on fire for God. And,
that's wonderful.
And we are looking forward to have you by the end of this year, Dr. Paul. It's going to be tremendous.
I am excited about it. I'm asking the Lord to... Now, Dr. Girgis, you got to get me well enough to go to Uganda, okay?
At your service, sir.
Yes, yes. Just leave it right here.
Yes, sir.
But I will personally take charge of that. Listen, we've got just a brief little roll-in. We're so excited. How many years ago did we actually dedicate the Full Power TV station?
It's about 10 years ago.
Almost 10 years ago?
Almost 10 years ago.
I remember being there, and I forget who it was that was your president at the time.
Yeah, no, actually the president could not come. He was out of the country, but he sent the Minister of the Information, Dr. Rugunda.
Okay.
Yes, who came and...
Okay, it's just a little over a minute, but it'll bring back a beautiful memory when we dedicated another full-power TV station in Africa.
Kampala is the largest city in Uganda, the Pearl of Africa. It is also Uganda's capital city and the home of Lighthouse Television. Right in the heart of Kampala stands Lighthouse Television, a Trinity Broadcasting Network affiliate and a family education and Christian station with a mission to provide the moral foundation that Uganda needs in its struggle for development. Lighthouse Television was officially opened in August of 1997 in a grand ceremony that was witnessed by many dignitaries, including the then Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda, the founder and president of Trinity Broadcasting Network, Dr. Paul Crouch, and the founder and senior pastor of Calvary Cathedral International, Dr. Bob Nichols. Now, since its opening, Lighthouse Television continues to proclaim the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ to the people of Uganda through faith-based programs that cut across all age groups. As an affiliate of Trinity Broadcasting Network in Africa, Lighthouse Television has many international programmers that are well experienced in teaching and preaching God's word. Thank you, Trinity Broadcasting Network, for your unwavering support and partnership in the spreading of the gospel of Jesus Christ to Uganda.
Oh, wonderful. What a joy to just have you both here today and to rejoice over what God has done and now is continuing to do in Africa, the Middle East, and now it blows my mind, Dr. Girgis, how many Arab colonies there are all over Europe and the world.
Yeah, and the United States and Canada, big, big people.
Shouldn't we tell them also
Yeah, we are on galaxy 19.
19, which is, we call it Glory Star, and it's one of the satellites. It covers all of North America.
North America and the Caribbean.
And the Caribbean.
And, you know, including Mexico.
Yes. And so any of you watching this program, it's also on there. Help us spread the word.
Amen.
That galaxy 19 is it. You know what? We've got a couple of extra minutes. If you've just tuned us in, Al-Haraya means?
Freedom.
Freedom in the Arabic language. And this is the Al-Haraya new television set that we've been working on for several months. And we're so excited that it's now in full use. And it's being used and will be continued to use every day or every week to do live programming.
In Jesus' name.
One more minute of your time, please. Watch it carefully. And then we'll have a final goodbye.
TBN is reaching the world through the Arabic language channel Al Horaya.
لأنه صمم الأمثال للتعليم المبادئ الدينية والدروس الأدبية.
24 hours a day, the gospel is sent in Arabic to Europe, North Africa, and the Middle East.
God healed me instantly. I don't take medicine or painkiller anymore.
جات في العدد الأول والعدد 19 والعدد 25.
Unrest and change may be spreading through the region, but high above, TBN satellites beam Al Horaya's message of hope and freedom to hundreds of millions in the cradle of civilization. The Al Horaya Channel, just part of the Trinity Broadcasting family of networks around the world.
Oh, Lord, 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 what a day to be alive. Gentlemen, do you realize that we are literally being used of God to help fulfill Bible prophecy?
Amen.
Isaiah 19, read it for yourself. Our time is gone, and I want to take us out with a beautiful song that the Gaither Gang sing, and it couldn't be more appropriate than this particular day in which we live. It says, keep us safe till the storm passes by. Enjoy it.
In the dark of the midnight, have I oft hid my face, while the storm howls above me, and there's no hiding place. Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry, keep me safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand
and the storms come no more. Let me stand in thy presence on that bright, peaceful shore, in that land where the tempest never comes. Lord, may I dwell with thee till the storm. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder.